I'm Tim Brenneman, plant pathologist at University of Georgia in Tifton, and today I'm going to tell you a little bit about white mold disease in peanuts. White mold is a disease that's really bad on peanuts, especially in hotter years. It's not a new disease, we've had it for many years. This shows what the disease looks like. It can be hard to see until you dig the peanuts because it grows often below ground. So the best time to diagnose this disease is after the peanuts are inverted, as these have just been dug yesterday, and it attacks usually at the crown of the plant and then spreads to the lower stems. It can also grow very well on the pods. You'll see that a lot of these pods are gone. They should have pods like you see here, but these pods have all been rotted by the fungus. You can see the reason we call it white mold. You can see the white mycelium here on the stems, and these pods are just starting to be rotted. They often will have sort of a fuzzy appearance, or a lot of times the soil will cling to the pods like you see there, and that's because of the fungus growing into the pods and out into the soil, and it lets the soil particles cling to those. This is the sweet spot for our peanut yield, right here around the taproot. These are our oldest, largest, most mature pods. They will weigh the most, so that's the bulk of your yield, is right around there, the taproot crop. And that's the first peanuts that get taken off when this disease infects the plant. The bottom line, or underlying practice that's most helpful, is a good crop rotation. So the longer you can stay out of a host crop like peanuts, if you can grow something like corn or cotton, soybeans is not a good choice, but that will decrease the amount of disease in the soil and decrease the amount of disease you'll have.